Welcome to this service of Holy Communion for Resurrection Day. Let's light our candle. Jesus is the light of the world. In him there is no darkness at all. Where Jesus is, the darkness has to flee. Hallelujah. The Lord be with you. Hallelujah. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. Hallelujah. We start with our first hymn, which is number 76, Christ the Lord is risen today. Number 76. We say our prayer of preparation together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, our Passover lamb, has been sacrificed for us. Let us therefore rejoice by putting away all malice and evil and confessing our sins with a sincere and true heart. And we say together, most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we say the Gloria together. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And the Collect for Easter Day. Lord of all life and power, who through the mighty resurrection of your Son overcame the old order of sin and death, to make all things new in him, grant that we, being dead to sin and alive to you in Jesus Christ, may reign with him in glory, to whom with you in the Holy Spirit be praise and honour and glory and might, now and in all eternity. Amen. Our first reading is taken from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 25, beginning at verse 6. On this mountain, the Lord Almighty will prepare a feast of rich food for all people, a banquet of aged wine, the best of meats, the finest of wines. On this mountain he will destroy the shroud that enfolds all peoples, the sheet that covers all nations. He will swallow up death forever. The Sovereign Lord will wipe away the tears from all their faces. He will remove the disgrace of his people from all the earth. The Lord has spoken. In that day they will say, "Surely this is our God. We trusted in him, and he saved us. This is the Lord. We trusted in him. Let us rejoice and be glad in his salvation." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our second reading is taken from Acts, chapter 10, beginning at verse 34. Peter began to speak. "I now realize how true it is that God does not show favoritism, but accepts men from every nation who fear him and do what is right. You know the message God sent to the people of Israel, telling the good news of peace through Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. You know what has happened through Judea, beginning in Galilee, after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, and how he went around doing good and healing all who were under the power of the devil, because God was with him. We are witnesses of everything he did in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They killed him by hanging him on a tree. But God raised him from the dead on the third day and caused him to be seen. He was not seen by all people, but by witnesses whom God had already chosen, by us who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one whom God appointed as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our second hymn is number 331, 331, In Heavenly Love Abiding. Alleluia, alleluia. I am the first and the last, says the Lord, and the living one. I was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. John chapter 20, beginning at the first verse. Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciple, the one that Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb and we don't know where they've put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter, who was behind him, arrived and went straight into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the burial cloth that had been around Jesus' head. The cloth was folded up by itself, separate from the linen. Finally, the other disciple who'd reached the tomb first also went inside. He saw and believed. But they still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to their homes, but Mary stood outside the tomb, crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white, seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken the Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they've put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus. "Woman," he said, "why are you crying? Who is it that you are looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you've put him and I will go and get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned towards him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet returned to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them that I am returning to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord." And she told them all that had been said to her. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Let's bow our heads to pray. May I speak in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and bring glory to you alone. Amen. Today is the culmination of the divine story of love, where God reached out to sinful humanity to restore a perfect relationship with him forever. But at what cost? The suffering and humiliation and torture and death of the Son of God. And the incredible thing about this story of love for us and for you and for me is that there's nothing we can do to earn it. There's no good deed. There's no life-changing experience. There's no religious activity. There's no kindness. Even if I give all that I have to the poor and my body to be burnt, says 1 Corinthians 13, without love, I am nothing. And love reaches out for love's response. And that response is a testimony. Scripture says that they overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Not theory, not theological treaties, not reading or quoting from other writers or clever people, but by a life transformed by the presence of Jesus in your life. And that comes at the foot of the cross, when we realize our sinfulness and our brokenness and are all that we have is just filthy rags. And in repentance, we come with a broken and contrite heart and ask for forgiveness. And out of grace and his immeasurable mercy, we are washed with the blood of the Lamb. And though our sins are as scarlet, they are as white as snow. And then as we are cleansed and we invite Jesus into our lives, the Holy Spirit starts a work in us to challenge, to cajole, to teach, to change, so that we can be God's ambassadors in Jesus' name, with a story to share, with a transformed life to be seen. It should be that people don't even need us to open our mouths to see something is different. But it takes a time, it takes a long time. Some people it takes a lifetime, because we're all a work in progress. But as we yield to the Lord, bit by bit, unknown to us, we become more loving, more caring, servant hearts. Our hard heart is replaced with a heart of flesh, with compassion. And we become more Christ-like. Less of me, Lord, more of you. Sometimes this will come with conflict, because people who walk in darkness feel challenged and convicted. You don't have to say anything or do anything, and they might lash out. But our task is to love them and pray for them. Jesus on the cross said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." And when he looked down from the cross in that terrible agony, he saw his mother and John, the disciple he loved. And in the midst of the terror and torture, he cared about his mother and John and said, "Mother, here is your son. Son, here is your mother." Even then, he wasn't thinking of himself. And then when it went dark, and Jesus cried out, "Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani? My God, why have you forsaken me?" The first time ever that God had to turn away because of all the sins that he bore for us. I can well imagine that Satan taunted him, "Ha, you failed. I have won. Look, let me show you what your humanity, you love so much, have done. With all the wars and the tortures and the rapes, the genocides, the terrible wickedness of humankind, the rejection, the false religion, the greed, the abuse, the sin." So Resurrection Day, although it's a time of victory and joy and celebration, we should never forget what led to this time. And we should never forget that the Lord has promised that those who draw close to him, he will draw close to them, and he will never leave us or forsake us. So make your choice. Be more like Jesus today. If you find it difficult, well, we all find it difficult, ask the Lord through the Holy Spirit to help you. And he will. And then you will find the victory and the joy in your heart, because the penny will drop and you will know how incredible that the King of Kings and Lord of Lords and Sovereign of all, to whom every knee shall bow and every tongue confess, loves you. with an everlasting love. And their arms around you, and he's carved you in the palm of his hand, precious, redeemed, ransomed. Hallelujah. Amen. We say the creed together. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and we look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray. And Lord Jesus, as we come to celebrate and rejoice in your victory over death and sin, we pray that you will come and pour out your blessed Holy Spirit to give us a revelation of the depth and height and breadth of your love for us, that the earth may be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God as the waters cover the sea. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our nation, for our Queen and the royal family. We pray for Prince Philip and his speedy recovery. We pray for our Prime Minister and our government during these difficult times. And we pray that you lead our nation to truth, your truth, and that we will repent and you will forgive our land and heal our land and heal us. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we pray for the nations of the world, particularly those that are in conflict, those who are suffering from natural disasters. We pray, mighty God, for your blessing on your people. We pray also, Lord Jesus, for those who are persecuted for their faith, that you'll be with them, that you will strengthen them, encourage them, provide for them, be with them and keep them safe. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And Lord, there are many people who are on our hearts, those who are sick, those who are in need, those who are lonely, those who are depressed, those who are bereaved. We pray for Jim and Jenny in Scotland, for Dave, for Bill and Alan, for Jeff and family, for Chris's mum, for Craig in America and his sister Karen. We pray for Mick with dementia and his wife Mary and Terry and Enid, who are supporting. Pray for Pam, for Dorothy. Pray for Richard and his wife, Ruth. Pray for John. Pray for Lindsay, Janet B and Chris. For Philip and his wife, Beryl. For Barry. For Mark Madeley. For Peter and for Mark. Pray for Anne Williams and Mike Tierney in Whitford. For John and Sheila, Yvonne and Chris with long COVID. For Mr. Lewis. For Caroline. For Aubrey and Catherine. Teresa. Janet and Glyn. Katrina. Baby William is doing well, but for James, his dad, and Jess's mum, who's got COVID. But also we pray a blessing on Lucy and Darren and Esther, for Morgan and Martina, for Zach, for Brian, for Trevor, for Maya, Sheila, Pauline. And we pray for ourselves, for your healing, for your presence, and for your blessing at this resurrection time. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. The risen Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, Shalom, peace be with you. Then were they glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia, the peace of the Lord be always with you. Now we're going to have a piece of music to listen to reflect on this incredible fact that Jesus is alive.
Son of man, he will.
Blessed are you, Lord God, King of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to set before you, which earth has given and human hands has made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God, King of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to set before you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us the cup of salvation. Blessed be God forever. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal Father. And in these days of Easter, to celebrate with joyful hearts the memory of your wonderful works. For by the mystery of his passion, Jesus Christ, your risen Son, has conquered the powers of death and hell and restored in men and women the image of your glory. He has placed them once more in paradise and opened to them the gate of life eternal. And so, in the joy of this Passover, earth and heaven resound with gladness, while angels and archangels and the powers of all creation sing forever the hymn of your glory. And we say together, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit that broken bread and wine outpoured may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he praised you. He broke the bread and gave it to them and said, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he praised you. He gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you, for this is my blood of a new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. And bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes again in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes, and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on these, your people. Gather us in your loving arms, and bring us with all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory are yours, loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. we break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in the one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Alleluia, Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. And we say together, most merciful Lord, your love compels us to come in. Our hands were unclean, our hearts were unprepared. We were not fit even to eat the crumbs from under your table. But you, Lord, are the God of our salvation, and share your bread with sinners. So cleanse and feed us with the precious body and blood of your Son, that he may live in us and we in him, and that we with the whole company of Christ may sit and eat in your kingdom. Amen. The body of Christ, keep you in eternal life. The blood of Christ, keep you in eternal life. Let us pray. God of life, who for our redemption gave your only begotten Son to death on the cross, and by his glorious resurrection have delivered us from the power of our enemy, grant us so to die daily to sin, that we may evermore live with him in the joy of his risen life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And we say together, Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. Our next hymn is number 1072, In Christ Alone.
Christ alone, my heart is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still. Sees my comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stay. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness by the ones he came to save, till on that cross as Jesus. Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied, for every sin on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live.
The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with each one of you, all whom you love, cherish, and pray for, this day and forevermore. Amen. And because this is Resurrection Sunday, let's have another song to rejoice in. Easter Jubilation.
Easter Jubilation fills the streets and towns. Celebrations have begun. Hear the music and the dancing now. Join the laughter and the fun. Oh, put aside your sorrows, wipe your tears away. For a better time will come. There's a promise of a brighter day. Join the laughter and the fun. Oh, raise a joyful shout. Clap your hands and dance, set your feelings out.
Go in peace to serve the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia. In the name of Christ, alleluia, alleluia. So until next time, it's a big God bless you from me, Greg. Bye.